لله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يقول عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه: إذا رأيت فقيرا يمشي في سكك المدينة فاعلم أن هناك غنيا لم يدفع زكاته. إذا رأيت فقيرا يمشي في سكك المدينة فاعلم أن هناك غنيا لم يدفع زكاة ماله. Look and reflect on the saying of Umar رضي الله عنه. He said, if you see a poor person walking in the streets of Medina, know for sure that there is a rich person who did not pay the zakah of his wealth. SubhanAllah. When we look at our teachings, when we look at Islam, when we look at the Quran, look at the Sunnah, and we look at the commands of the zakah, and how Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu fought the Muslims when they refused to pay the zakah in the apostasy war on the road of Libya. When we reflect on how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala connected the zakah with the salah and all the ayat, to show that salah is the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the zakah is the right of the people. When we look at the ayah that commands Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, خُذْ مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ صَدَقَةً تُطَهِّرُهُمْ وَتُزَكِّيهِمْ بِهَا, take from their wealth the zakah as a form of purification for their wealth and a way to increase the blessing of their money. When we think about the saying of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in reference to the zakah, the money that you take out of your wealth, أَوْسَاخُ النَّاسِ, it is the filth of people. And when he told his grandson not to eat the date, he took it out of his mouth, dug deep to take that date from a child's mouth, because he said this is the filth of people. It's not right for the Ummah or for the family of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you take a look at it, it is the filth of the people. Whose people? Rich people. But it's the purest form for the one who receives it. It's like my clothes are dirty. What do I do? I keep the spot on it because I'm going to take care of my clothes so I will not ruin the fabric or whatever. I remove it. But I want to look good. I want something clean. You have your money. Zakah, if it stays in the money, it contaminates it. It's filth. It has to be taken and removed so your money will grow and you have a blessing in your money. And those people who catches it are the one who will grow with it and live with it. 2.5% that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala obligated will suffice the need of every person needing. All the poverty that you see in the universe, Muslim, if they pay their zakah, they will not have any problems. Look how Umar radiallahu anhu understood it. If you see one poor person walking, that means there's a rich person who did not pay, because if he paid, that poor person is not asking people for help. That means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he revealed the Quran and the commands, Tanzeelun min Hakimin Hamid, the most wise, the most knowing, the most praiseworthy, that when he said 2.5%, this 2.5% will take care of the needy people. And in cases of emergencies, we know how much we are commanded to just go ahead and give extra charity. In fact, the ruler has the right to impose more zakah on rich people accordingly to suffice the need of the needy people. That tells you how much people living nowadays, they're not paying zakah. Or how much people pay zakah and it's not going to the right people to receive it. It really, and when I read that and I reflected on it, I said, SubhanAllah, poor people are more and more by the millions, and one single person can really suffice maybe a whole country from his zakat. But then again, SubhanAllah, people don't reflect on that. And people who can be probably listening to me right now or in the future, not really paying their zakat the way it's supposed to be, or not taking care of extra cautions on their money when they calculate it to pay for it, or delaying it, or giving it in installments as if it's their money. You don't give zakat in installments unless it's advanced. If you have zakat due today, $1,000, you take that $1,000 and you send it to the people. It's haram to keep it. Even in the masjid, you're supposed to take it and deliver it to the people. It's no longer yours. It's haram to keep. This is a form of oppression. You're taking the rights of other people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made upon you, just like a person refusing to divide inheritance. It's no longer the deceased person's money. It has to go. No one has the right to keep it. It's no longer their money. It is the money of those who are inherited. The same thing when it comes to zakat. So brothers and sisters, make sure that you are taking good care and paying not just the money that you owe, pay more, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is more generous than to not give you your money back. One for 10 to 700 or even more. If you give in the form of charity, imagine when it is an obligation. This is like saying Sunnah Fajr is better than this whole universe. Can you imagine the fard? How much? If you say the extra charity is up to 700 or more, can you imagine the zakah itself is how much? It's a pillar. It's a pillar of your faith that deserved war against you if you don't pay. And Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anh did fulfill that, because he said, I will fight anyone who separates between Salah and Zakah when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger connected them together. Take care of your charity and Zakah, inshaAllah, and inshaAllah you will be in the right way.
Can I ask a question?
Sure.
When do you think, or what is your opinion, as to when a person say he's not eligible anymore for zakat?
That's exactly what Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu did.
Yes.
When Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam died, the weak believers and hypocrites and such, I said, we used to pay it to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now he's dead, we don't have to pay. What did Umar Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu do? So it's the same thing. Now if there is no specific person to give it to, like a ruler, then it's an obligation on yourself. You take care of it. And there are many organizations who do. Let's say that you give it to someone you trust and they did not send it to the right place. In the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you did your part. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. So whether you have someone to receive it or not to receive it, it has to be paid. To the point that they used to put it on the side of the road. At the time of Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, Allahu A'lam, used to put it on the side of the road, and the person comes, look at the quality of the believers that they have. You take that bag, I needed $100, I take $100. There's $1,000 there. I would not take the $1,000 out of greed. Look how Izzat al-Nafs can. They take $100 and they leave that bag where it is for someone else to get it. Can you say that on the salad bar about Muslims nowadays? Salad bar, I'm not going to say hundreds of dollars. They're ready to fill 10 plates and you've got a big line behind them and they will not end up eating because you want to make sure that you get all you can handle plus. That's a sad situation.
We need this kind of instructions more often, Sheikh. To remind people about zakah. We hardly hear about zakah. We hear a lot about sadaqah, sadaqah.
Sahih.
Yeah, he don't hear much about zakat.
Unfortunately, and I can elaborate more, because the reason I said you pay it right away, because some people, they have zakat, and they hold it, and someone comes for ask, here's $100, and he keeps doing that, and he acts as if he's giving them or doing them a favor. Back home, they consider giving the zakat a favor. I've been giving him, I give this, and I give that, and it's zakat money.
Is that right?
Yeah.
So once when it leaves your hand, then that's it.
Yes. When the zakat is due, it is dirt, you need to get out of it. Yeah, I mean, get it out of it. The cat who?
Cannot be paid installment unless it's advance. If you pay in advance, you can pay installment, but you cannot pay it.
Exactly. Like if you want to make sure that you pay the zakat, you can give now and write it down, and next year, how much you owe, you can subtract that from the money. You can pay advance, but once it's due, you cannot keep it and give installments.
Okay.
Allah. Subhanakallah.